Amen. Our God is an awesome God. Good morning, brothers and sisters. For this, our awesome God is God Almighty. Let us give Him praise this morning. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto Thy name, O Most High. Our Father and our God, wonderful God, we praise You, Lord, for You are trustworthy and You reveal Yourself to those who sincerely look for You. Lord, our mighty God, awesome, omnipotent God, we praise You, Lord, for nothing and no one can be compared to You. Lord, be glorified. Hallelujah be to Your name, Lord, great and faithful Father. We praise You, for You are faithful. You are the one who give us all things to enjoy. Lord, be exalted in our life this morning. Be exalted, O Lord, our God. Yes, Father, we are Your children. We have come into Your presence this morning. And Lord, we know, we recognize that You are holy. Lord God Almighty, we are asking You that You will forgive us of our sins, Lord. Forgive us, Father God Divine, in the name of Jesus. Whatever will be in hindrance to our prayer this morning, we're asking You, Lord, that the blood of Jesus Christ will cleanse us from all unrighteousness, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, because Your word says, if anyone cleanses himself from these things, he will be a vessel for honor, sanctified, useful to the master, prepared for every good work. Lord Jesus, You are the master of all things. This name speaks to Your rule and authority above all. What You command happens. What You desire comes about. You set the stars in their spots. You hung the planet where they are. You place the moon so that it can reflect light at night and guide us. You are the master of our soul. We worship You this morning, for You are great. For Your great might, we honor You, for You rule, Your rule of mercy. Lord Jesus, our Master, we lift up Your name, Master, as we surrender our will to Your own way this morning, Lord, that You have Your way in our life, Lord. Have Your way, Lord. Lord Jesus, as we go about our days, we often get distracted by our own desires. The world wants us to think that we are the master of our life. And when we are giving us free will, when we choose to act on our own as our own master and living Your will and entering into a state of chaos and sin, forgive us, Lord, for mixing Your word with the world's word. Forgive us for questioning Your authority as master. Give us mercy for those times that we choose sin over following You. Gossiping, envy, hate, apathy toward others. These things easily appear in our hearts when we are not living in surrender to You. We lay our ambitions before Your rule this morning, Lord, our Master. Thank You, Lord Jesus, for Your attributes of control, power, and strength and might. Thank You for guiding us into Your perfect will, which leads to life. Thank You for allowing us to know You and serve You as our Master. You make miracles with a single thought because You are the Master overall. And You take delight in us when we recognize You as the Master. We give You the gratitude of our hearts as we honor You as the Master who controls all. When circumstances look like they are out of control, they are simply out of our own control. But You are the master who rules over all. So Lord, that is the confidence that we have this morning, coming into Your presence, that You are the master over all, every situation, every circumstances. Lord Jesus, we want to have the faith of the man of whom You marvel. In Matthew 8:8-10 says, the centurion said, Lord, I'm not worthy for You to come under my roof, But just say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I am a man under authority, with soldiers under me. And I say to this one, go, and he goes. And to another, come, and he comes. And to my slave, do this, and he does it. Now when Jesus heard this, he marveled and said to those who have fallen, truly, I say to you, I have not found such great faith with anyone in Israel. Lord Jesus, give us this faith. Give us this faith, Lord, this Jesus. Let us be a vehicle through which you work your miracle because of our trust in your name, Master. Master, that is what it means. Whatever the Master say, we must do. You are able to do more than we could ever imagine, both in and through us. Like the Father in Mark chapter 9 verse 24 say, we ask for you to help our unbelief so that we can live in faith and surrender to you, Lord Jesus, our Master. Rule over every situation this morning. Take control, Lord Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, hallelujah. This morning, we're going to, by the grace of God, this morning, we're going to look at dealing with negative emotions and strongholds. Before we pray, let me quickly enlighten us so we can know how we direct our prayer appropriately. 2 Corinthians 10:3 4 say, for though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. Strongholds are negative mindsets and behavior that are buried inside us, working against our very own life without our knowing it. They are belief and attitude patterns that the enemy plant in us and just walk away. While we struggle with them, it just goes on to build further resistance against other aspects of our life. Yesterday, we surrendered ourselves to the Lord and began a new relationship with the Holy Spirit. So this morning, we're going to take things further. We're going to rely on the Holy Spirit to speak into our lives and command every negative habit and strongholds that gives the devil a leeway to build a blockade over our lives and destiny. We're going to receive total empowerment to break free from personal habits and attitudes that are inimical to our spiritual and physical progress. And there are three ways we can deal with strongholds. The first way is to identify the strongholds. The second one is to attack the strongholds. And the third way is to believe and declare your victory every day. You declare your victory. When we try to identify the strongholds, what are they? I will mention some quickly. Number one, anger. And under anger, you have very things that can come out under anger. Hatred, malice, rage, murder, you know, cursing, vengeance, retaliation, cruelty, being judgmental, critical, taking offense easily, irritability. All these are strongholds that we must deal with. The second one is fear. Either fear of man, fear of authority, doubt, unbelief, it manifests in this way. Fear of disease, fear people will get angry with you or fear that people will not like you. These are strongholds because with that fear controlling our life, it makes us to do things that are not pleasing to God. The third one, abandonment, that is desertion, divorce, rejection, neglect, not valuing people, not valuing relationship, and ending relationship, burning the bridges, loneliness, self-pity. All these are strongholds in our life. Shames, guilt, withdrawal, timidity, inferiority, underlying, cheating will come in, theft, deception, self-deception, hiding purchases, activities, relationships, untrustworthiness. These are strongholds that we must sit down and think about. Financial lack, that is some belief in poverty, or robbing God by not paying your tithes, not believing in covenant blessing, greed, covetousness, debt, dishonesty. You know you cannot afford the thing, excuse me, this morning. But you use your credit card. Some of us use the credit card to the maximum. You use credit card to pay credit card. Purchases that you don't need, you keep buying them. Those are strongholds. Idolatry of possession. Addiction is another stronghold. It can be to alcohol, to tobacco, to drugs, to food, to sugar, to coffee, to chocolate, pornography, flirtation, TV, movies, everything, overeating, drinking too much, anything you cannot do in moderation is an addiction and it's a stronghold. And we have lost fantasizing, depression is there, it's a stronghold. Under depression we have rejection, despair, helplessness, hopelessness, and grief is another stronghold where we have sorrow, despair, heartache, loss, pain, torment, weeping, anguish, and agony. These are the strongholds that we must identify. We must identify the strongholds. Pride is a stronghold. Arrogance. Callousness. Lack of concern for others and gossip is a stronghold. We must identify it. And procrastination. Lack of focus. Not thinking things through before acting or speaking or writing emails. Lack of organization or preparation. Lateness, tardiness. Missing appointment or phone calls. All these are strongholds that we must identify. And by the grace of God, we will identify them and attack them. We attack these strongholds and put them down by presenting them before the Lord in prayer. And as we do, we receive grace to overcome them on a daily basis. And we believe and declare the victory every day. We must know that the enemy will come back over and over again to try to rebuild a stronghold. But as we continue to confess and declare our victory in Christ, and renew our minds with God's word, these strongholds are permanently defeated in the name of Jesus. So this morning, we're going to confess the word of God, and then we're going to pray that the Lord will help us in these strongholds. So this morning, let us go to the word of God this morning and make our confession. Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 2 says, therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. His good, pleasing, and perfect will. Amen. Psalm 1 verses 1 to 3 say, blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers. Hallelujah. The last one, 2 Corinthians 10, verse 4 to 5. Say, the weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. And we take captive every thought to make it obedience to Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning, let us pray, my Father. My Lord, I come to you today to surrender my body and I hand over my thought to you. Lord, I come before you this morning and to surrender my body to you. I hand over my thought to you this morning. I dedicate my mind, my imagination, and my attitude to you henceforth in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, I dedicate my mind, my imagination, and my attitude to you henceforth in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us pray. Oh Lord, uproot out of my life every inner argument and unbelief contesting your word in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, uproot out of my life every inner argument and unbelief contesting your word in my life. Lord, uproot them. Uproot them in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I hereby arrest every negative thought in me, resisting the move of the Holy Spirit. I command these thoughts to wither by fire right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I hereby arrest every negative thought in me, resisting the move of the Holy Spirit. I command this thought to wither. To wither in the name of Jesus Christ. Let this thought wither in the name of Jesus Christ by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. Let this thought wither in the name of Jesus Christ. I arrest every negative thought in me, resisting the move of the Holy Spirit, and I command this thought to wither in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray that every spiritual stronghold in my life, walking against the knowledge of God, I pull you down in the name of Jesus Christ. Right now, every spiritual stronghold in my life, walking against the knowledge of God, I pull you down. I pull you down right now in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, by the authority in the word of God. Every spiritual stronghold in the life, in our life, walking against the knowledge of God, I pull you down right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Pray with me this morning that in the name of Jesus, I command all the false gods contesting for worship in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to die by fire right now. All the false gods contesting for worship in my life. In the name of Jesus, die by the fire of God. Die by fire. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. Amen. Every bad habit in my life, causing a barrier between me and the power of God. Oh Lord, let your fire destroy them. Today, oh Lord, let your fire destroy them. Every bad habit in my life, causing a barrier between me and the power of God. Oh Lord, let your fire destroy them. Let your fire destroy them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. My Lord and my Father, every bad habit in my life that is causing a barrier between me and the power of God, fire of God, consume them. Fire of God, consume them in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. From today, Lord Jesus, plant in me an everlasting hatred for lust, anger, bitterness, alcoholism, You name stronghold you have identified as your challenge this morning. Name them, whether it's drinking, overeating, in the mighty name of Jesus, you pray that, Father, my Lord and my Father, plant in me an everlasting hatred for lust, for anger, for bitterness, for gossip. Lord, plant in me for drinking or smoking, overeating, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, I claim my freedom from every destructive habit in the name of Jesus Christ. I claim my freedom from every destructive habit in the name of Jesus Christ. Some of us have heard, we know that sugar is not good for us. You still take that Coke, you drink it. You still take that sugar, you eat it. Oh, Father, Lord, this morning, hey, we are self-destructive, oh Lord. We are asking you that you will deliver us from every self-destruction that we are causing to our body in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, pray this morning that you spirit of anger, you spirit of lust, you spirit of dishonesty, lying, spiritual laziness, pride and exaggeration, whatever it is this morning that you have challenged with, command that spirit that in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of Jesus, I am set free from you. I am set free from you. And I command you all to live my life right now and go into the abyss in the name of Jesus Christ. Begin to bind that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. That spirit that is making you to take. You hear the word. You hear that this thing is not good, but you still persist in it. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let the spirit of anger be arrested this morning. Let the spirit of dishonesty be arrested. The spirit of lust, the spirit of laziness, the spirit of pride and exaggeration. In the name of Jesus Christ, we arrest you this morning. In our life, in the name of Jesus Christ, the spirit of criticizing. Oh, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we are free from you forever. Free, but because of the blood of Jesus Christ, we command you all to live our life now in the name of Jesus Christ, and go to the abyss in Jesus' name. Amen. Pray that, oh Lord, my Father, whatever evil effect upon my life resulting from my character, from my past mistakes, or addiction to negative thoughts, words, or habits, Lord, set me free in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, whatever evil effects upon my life resulting from my characters, from my past mistake or addiction to negative thoughts, words, and habits, Lord, set me free. Set me free, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus. Pray this morning that, oh Lord, whatever curse and obstacle my wrong association and friendship have brought upon my life, let them be destroyed today, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, whatever curse and obstacles my wrong associations and friendship have brought upon my life, Lord, let them be destroyed. Today, Lord, let them be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Pray, my Father, from now onwards, surround me with the right people. Surround me with people who will challenge me toward a godly and excellent life. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, my Father, from now onward, oh Lord, surround me, surround my family with the right people. Surround us with people who will challenge us toward a godly and excellent life. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, our Father, you are the one that can match two people together. Lord God Almighty, separate us, oh Lord, from all the evil ones, Lord, and surround us with the right people who will challenge us toward godly and excellent life, in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Pray that from today, Almighty Father, I commit myself never to walk in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the way of sinners, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, Almighty God, I commit myself never to walk in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the way of sinners, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, I commit myself to delight in the word of God and fellowship. I shall henceforth depend on your word day and night, and his power shall work in me always to bear the right fruit, in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray this morning, I commit myself to delight in the word of God and fellowship. I shall henceforth depend on God's word today and night, and his power shall work in me always to bear the right fruits in the name of Jesus Christ. Declare to yourself this morning that I am like a tree planted by the river, by the side of the river. My strength shall not fail. From season to season, I shall bear fruit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Make that declaration louder as you go this morning. That in the name of Jesus Christ, I'm like a tree planted by the rivers, by the side of the river. My strength shall not fail. My season, from season to season, I shall bear fruit. I shall bear fruit in the name of Jesus Christ. From season to season, I shall bear fruit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lastly, let us pray that in the name of Jesus, Father, Lord, I pray that every spirit of distraction and weakness, I bind you and I cast you into the abyss in the name of Jesus Christ. Every spirit of distraction and weakness, as I go about my daily business today, I bind you and I cast you into the abyss in the name of Jesus Christ. I forbid distraction that will come in any manner to take me away from seeking the Lord. And as I have decided, in the name of Jesus, I forbid every form of spiritual laziness and discouragement in the name of Jesus. In my life, in my household, I forbid every form of spiritual laziness and discouragement in the name of Jesus Christ. And I decree that I have strength and power to wait on the Lord this day and all other coming days and nights in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree that I have strength and power to wait on the Lord this day and all other coming nights in the name of Jesus Christ. I soak my spirit, my soul, and my body completely in the blood of Jesus Christ. I soak my spirit, my soul, and my body completely in the blood of Jesus Christ. According to the book of Exodus 12:13, it says, "The blood shall be to me for a token upon my life and family, and when the angel of death shall see the blood, it shall pass over, and the plague shall not rest upon me and my household in the name of Jesus Christ." Let me repeat that again. According to the book of Exodus 12:13, "The blood shall be to me for a token upon my life and my family, and when the angel of death shall see the blood, it shall pass over, and the plague shall not rest upon me and my household in the name of Jesus Christ." According to the book of Revelation 12:11, "I overcome the enemy by the blood of Jesus Christ. Therefore, I call upon the everlasting blood of Jesus Christ right now to erect a wall of protection over my life and my family in the name of Jesus Christ." I'm standing on the word of God this morning. According to the book of Revelation 12:11, "We are overcomers, the enemy, by the blood of Christ. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, I call upon the everlasting blood of Jesus Christ right now to erect a wall of protection over us, over our life, over our business, over our career, over our children, over our grandchildren, in the name of Jesus Christ." According to Zechariah 9:11, "By the blood of the covenant, I have sent forth thy prisoner out of the pit where there is no water." Because of this word, in the name of Jesus, I decree upon your life this morning that you will have freedom, you will have deliverance, you will have breakthrough by the blood of Jesus Christ and his covenant. You are coming out of the every pit where into you have been buried, where your breakthrough has been buried, where your blessings have been buried. They will be exhumed, and no power, no principality will be able to prevent you from moving forward in life and possessing your possession in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, our Lord and our God, for the victory that you are giving to us. Hallelujah be to your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Once again, I encourage us to pray this prayer. Take your time. Identify the stronghold in your life one by one and deal with it until we move on to the next one. So pray it over and over again as the Lord will enable you. God bless. Have a wonderful day. We meet tomorrow by the grace of God.